We are here at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, joined today by Cheryl McPhillips. Cheryl is NASA's Commercial Crew Program Partner Manager for the Sierra Nevada Corporation. Welcome.
Thank you.
As part of the Commercial Crew Program Integrated Capability, or CCICAP, NASA recently awarded $212.5 million to Sierra Nevada Corporation to keep things rolling and moving ahead. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
There was a competition, and Sierra Nevada was one of the three that was selected. And so they're planning to further develop their Dream Chaser system, which is a lifting body, which makes it kind of have a little bit more pizzazz maybe than some of the other vehicles. It also has some green technology propellants that are new that haven't been used before by NASA in any spacecraft. So we're pretty excited about it.
Yeah, it is exciting. And you are based here at Kennedy, and that is
That's
the
correct.
Home of the Commercial Crew Program. What were you doing prior to joining the Commercial Crew Program team?
Prior to joining Commercial Crew, I was working on Orion, the manned spacecraft that's going to do the exploration. And I also worked space station before that. And then eons ago when I started here, I worked Space Lab.
So now in your new role as the partner manager for Sierra Nevada, what roles do you have?
Basically, I'm the liaison between NASA and Sierra Nevada. So I'm kind of the communication conduit, if you will, between the two. I try to make sure that Sierra Nevada is successful and that anything that NASA has that they need, I try to advocate for them to get it. And also then I try to communicate back to NASA exactly what Sierra Nevada is doing, where their issues are, where their successes are, and how they're progressing.
So after the award of the CCICAP recently, did you hold some kickoff meetings?
Yes, just last week we had our first kickoff meeting out in Louisville, Colorado. So we discussed their whole plan to go from where they are today on their design to crewed orbital flight.
One of the new aspects that NASA has undertaken in this whole Commercial Crew Program is the Space Act Agreement. And can you tell us a little bit more about how that works for you, for NASA, and for the company?
Well, the Space Act Agreements are for public purpose. Basically, it's two parties coming together for a mutual goal. NASA's goal is to promote a commercial space transportation system, and Sierra Nevada's goal is, again, they want to have their Dream Chaser flying astronauts or even tourists or even doing other types of research in space. So we come together, NASA with some money and the Sierra Nevada Corporation with a design and hardware, and further it towards the mutual goal of flying humans in space.
So you, in your role as the partner manager, you're sort of an advocate for the company and for NASA. You're somewhat embedded in Sierra Nevada?
Correct. I have a person out, Valen Thorne, that's out in Louisville as my resident office, so I'm lucky that way, but I am traveling a lot out to Louisville to be with Sierra Nevada.
With the Space Act Agreement in place, Sierra Nevada and the other companies have a series of milestones that they must meet in order to make the monetary milestone gains that they're looking for.
Correct.
Can you tell us how that's all laid out and set up for Sierra Nevada?
For Sierra, we have 9 milestones. We just had our first one last week. Then we have 2 safety review milestones that will be coming up, and an integrated system baseline review, which kind of says this is where the system is right now. It's past the preliminary design review phase that we refer to. So we're going to get a baseline review and say this is how the hardware is, and then they'll go from there towards their critical design review, which is usually considered like 90% complete. Other major milestones they have their engineering test article, which they're going to drop from a helicopter. I don't know if you saw pictures of it during CCDEV2. They flew up below a helicopter. Anyhow, they're going to drop that in November and do some test landings. So that's a full-size mock-up.
You mentioned CCDEV2. Sierra Nevada has been a partner with NASA through that element as well. So they're not brand new.
No.
Is there
a
comfort level growing between the company and NASA?
Yes, I think we learned a lot during the CCDEV2 phase. We learned that sometimes we had different definitions that were called out in the milestones. The milestones have entrance and exit criteria that they have to meet in order to get paid for that milestone. And there were cases where we thought the milestones, the entrance and exit criteria stood for different things. So we've redefined those, and we're now trying to talk up front before the milestone and clear any expectations up before the milestone.
Well, there's a lot of excitement that is growing between NASA and all these companies. This is a real exciting time with the commercial partners. Can you sense the excitement from your role with NASA dealing
so closely? Well, I'm very excited to be working with Sierra Nevada and to be back around some hardware. You know, since the shuttle retired, it's been a little depressing around here. So it's good to be back with some flight hardware that's being built and to be with the company. And last week when I was out there, I was talking to one of the engineers for Sierra Nevada, and he was very excited about his actuator that is the hinge that connects their body flap to their space plane. And it was like he was talking about his child. He was just so excited.
Well, they are a unique company in this commercial crew program in that they have the lifting body, the HL-20 lifting body, it's based on NASA's HL-20. And it's also somewhat reminiscent then of the shuttle in the fact that it lands.
Yeah. I don't think they like to be called the little shuttle. So
no. But how does that how does that make you feel since you have been around flight hardware and shuttle hardware for so many years?
Well, I love to be around the hardware. You know, if I'm having a hard day, I used to always go down to the space station hardware and the SSPF and walk around the hardware just to kind of lift my spirits. So it's good to be able to be around some flight hardware again.
Well, when you're out and you're talking to your friends and family, how do you describe your job?
Well, I describe my job as working on the next space plane to take NASA astronauts to the International Space Station.
Great. Cheryl, thank you very, very much for being here today.
Well, thank you.